We done? Interviews done? We're done? No? What? Are you serious? Fuck. What's going on, guys? I'm Josh.
And I'm Kate.
And welcome back to Pilot Era. Did you know that we're famous now?
Sure are.
Well.
Look at me drinking out of this fancy glass.
Yeah, with a whole chili in there.
I thought it was funny. It's not. Oh, the gold leaf. It's so gross.
Mate, it's not in your mouth.
Might be. Hey. God. How do people do this?
Full-blown alcoholics, mate. So as you guys know, we released a video. Basically, we were obsessed with watching paranormal videos. We don't think there's anything wrong with paranormal videos. We actually quite enjoy them for their entertainment value. People were becoming way less skeptical and people were starting to believe them. And we totally understand they have to be presented in a way in which you should believe them.
Fake fear alive that there's paranormal shit everywhere.
The old no sleep thing. As a pre-release of that video, we released two of the clips that we made for the video. And we didn't really think much of it until we received this email.
Kyla. I didn't even know what his name was. That's such a weird name.
Well, don't give a guy shit for his name.
Hello, I'm writing to you on behalf of the YouTube channel Chills. We specialize in analyzing scary, mysterious videos online and recently reached 5 million subscribers. Your video, blah, 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 has been shortlisted to be featured and analyzed in one of our upcoming videos. We always provide links back to the original content, which will lead to a rise in new viewers to your channel. If for any reason you wish for your video not to be analyzed by us, please let us know in the next 72 hours and we'll honor your request. Regards, Kyla. Pretty exciting stuff.
When do you reckon the first time we read this?
Wasn't it like 2 weeks after?
It was 2-3 weeks after the email was sent, so it was way too late.
So they had free reign to go ahead and do whatever they wanted with our video because we didn't respond within 72 hours. Didn't read until 3 weeks after.
So for anybody who doesn't know, Chills is the same as every other compilation of scary video channel, but he does a very particular voice. Sort of sounds like this.
Number 5, SpongeBob. Have you ever heard the SpongeBob theme song played 800% slower? Well, you probably shouldn't, or it will haunt your dreams.
Don't be fooled by the rocks that I got.
Doesn't matter where I go, I'll always know where I came from.
The Bronx!
That's the most important part. The Bronx!
So that's the thing we've been doing for the last, like, week and a half.
I don't really know how that happened, but it's pretty fucking funny, in our opinion.
Welcome to our lives. We didn't really understand what was happening because we received this email.
I also just kind of realised that suddenly one of them was getting heaps of views. I was like, who the hell's watching this shit?
But then we found out that Chills actually hosts another channel called Top 15s.
Yes.
They take more of a sceptical approach to discussing these videos. It's good that it's out there.
Yeah.
It makes a lot of sense, but it sort of like breaks the immersion, so they've separated it onto this separate channel. All right, so we made it into Top 15 Scary Videos We Bet You Can't Handle.
Can't in capital letters.
I mean, I made one of them, so...
I'm sure we can handle it.
I think I can get through it.
This video has 170,560 views.
It's pretty good.
That's how many people have watched our fucking stupid video.
I know.
Oh, R.I.P.
It took us like another week on top of actually reading the email to find the damn thing.
Mm.
But here it is.
In all its glory.
Let's have a squiz at it.
Number 11, Paranormal Remodeling. Pilot Error Podcast claims to have had a poltergeist caught on camera in their kitchen. All of this can be done with two people and strings, in my opinion. So it's hard to say if this was a real poltergeist caught on tape or just a good scripted video.
Was it a well scripted video?
I think it was.
And who wrote the script?
Me.
On the fly.
My acting was sick, I thought.
I thought it was quite good.
But they cut out all that part.
Well, yeah, because most of it is you being like, fuck, fuck, fuck.
Good shit.
Yeah, I think they're trying to make, like... you know, some money.
Oh, yeah, it would get demonetized,
yes,
wouldn't
it? Yes, it would. So now let's watch our video.
It's fucking happening again. I can record it this time. Come on. Can you see that? The fuck? That's... They're all open. What the hell was that? Oh my god. Are you kidding me right now? Fuck! 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 How many times did I say fuck in that?
So many times.
Oh! You're allergic to our content.
I'm allergic to good content. That's why I only sneeze during our video. I think the main things we really need to focus on are, what are you drinking?
Right now, it's just a chili pepper infused Pinot Grigio.
Mm. Delicioso.
It's fantastic.
Obviously in the compilation, there's a huge dip in quality for some reason.
Yeah, they've made it more blurry for some reason, maybe to make it look realistic.
It's really obvious to us where they've cut all the audio out.
Yeah.
From all the swears.
Yeah, they could only use about 5 seconds of footage.
So they cut out the whip pan.
That's the impressive part of the video. Like, that's the part of the video that took the editing. Yeah, the point of why we did it. And that part looks so good in our version, I reckon.
Yeah.
The whip pan, like, because you were there on the floor.
Yeah.
And you don't see you. That was the whole point. I thought that was really impressive.
Everybody could do it. Two people in string. And you're like, yeah, that's how I did do it. You know, they've got a whole team. And that whole team could be two other people. I don't fucking know what the Chills team is. but they've got a team, which means that the team actually does research. So you think they'd see that the video that we put out originally, its title is Attack of the Red Circle, Paranormal Videos You Can Make Yourself. And they've put all these, like... all these effects and circles and arrows in our video that it really didn't need at all.
I think they were being, like, dickhead about it.
So I originally watched it and I thought they've understood the joke. But no, it's in all the videos in this compilation. Did they do the research or they just don't care?
They just need 15 videos. And how many of these do they make?
I mean, that's true.
They have to pump these out. One click onto our channel would have found it out.
Not actually linked in the comments, so... for you to find that out, you would have had to actually type in the name. Let's do it now. Pilot error podcast.
He also did have trouble saying the name of our channel.
Pilot error podcast.
There's our channel. Click that. Don't play that. And there it is. Attack of the Red Circle, 5 paranormal videos you can make yourself. So that's how long it takes you to work out that it's not real. So you really can't blame them. Because it's very easy to find out that it's not real. They wouldn't put it in the one where they're sort of pretending that it's real. They put it in this one. Benefit of the doubt for them, 100%. But the comments.
Oh my god, the comments are the best part.
So you got all these amateur internet sleuths in the comments. They're my favorite. So we're going to go through them now, which are really the point of this video. Is there are a lot of people out there who are skeptical and they watch these skeptical videos. And instead of taking 3 seconds... to prove that something's real, they think that their opinion about why it's not real is better than what we would call research.
Yeah. But we all know people on the internet don't actually research things.
We've got a real problem right now.
Fake news.
Fake news. They read like the headlines of shit and they don't actually read articles anymore.
Conspiracies.
We've had like a real life walkthrough of what that looks like here.
Yeah.
If they linked it, I would be more annoyed.
Yeah. But it would take longer to write a comment than to just type in the channel name.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So let's go through some of these comments together. When the couch is being pushed, you can see like a hand or something pushing it and going into the dark at number 11. That's not our video.
Incorrect.
Hmm. But maybe there was couch being pushed. You can see like a hand or something. Maybe like when you were sitting on the couch at the very, very start filming your legs.
Maybe there actually was a real paranormal.
There was like a real paranormal thing there. Shit. We'll have to go back and have a look.
It's fucking happening again. Shit. I hate when my perfectly lined up soda cans get whipped off the counter in order. Pesky organized ghosts. They were lined up pretty meticulously though.
Yeah, but they weren't pulled off in order.
Incorrect.
That's right. In your fucking face. But also, yeah, duh, gotta have something. And cans are free. Because they were sitting there.
And they make a good sound when they clatter on the floor. They're light, so they get whipped off and it looks effective.
Yeah.
It's just the best thing to use.
We told you it was fake. The video is to prove that they're fake and show you how they're fake.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Another one. Worried about the cans. I also don't feel like these people understand how messy our house is most of the time.
That's also true, yeah. Like, we actually, five is low.
So. We literally usually do have cans just like everywhere.
Yeah. Another one about the cans.
They're suspicious, lol. Number 11 is suspicious, lol. Why would they have a bunch of empty cans lined up for the video?
Also wrote out the whole word suspicious in 2021.
Yeah. Don't kid.
This person is a boomer.
Yeah, 100%. That person's like over 50, dude.
Number 11 could be done with BB gun also. How do you open cupboards with a BB gun?
But yeah, that's actually kind of a good idea though. It's like...
I like this one.
What the fuck? We live in a haunted condo? Ali H.
Yeah, I don't think so. We don't get her mail.
No. Oh my god. Wait. But he's moved and he's getting haunted at his new house, but whatever's haunting him is still here. So the ghost goes between properties?
No, we had a ghost in the last house. So here's our real paranormal thing from our lives. Are you ready? Ready for the story? I took steak that was frozen in our freezer and I put it in the refrigerator. And I came home after work and it was back in the freezer. Kate said she didn't do it.
No, it happened multiple times where like food especially would get moved around. Like, we had some poltergeist that was, like, hungry AF, I guess.
Or refreeze our food.
Just jealous that we could eat proper food, but he's a ghost, so we can't eat. So he's like, fuck you, I'm putting your steak back in the freezer so you can't eat it. I also used to have a ghost that would move my toys around. Like, put them in a cupboard. In a similar spot in the cupboard. My toys would go missing, and I'd check in this spot in the cupboard, and they were always there.
Maybe
and I told my parents about it. And they were like, oh, it must be Jack. Like, your brother, like, just...
It probably was, yeah.
No, but he was scared by it as well. So we both thought it was each other. And our parents were like, no, what if he's fucking with the other one? And, like, we never found out what was going on.
Yeah, you know what it was?
What?
They were fucking with you.
But why would they do that? We were frightened.
Yeah. They wanted to keep you scared.
Why they kept empty cans? Do people not leave trash around? Around 4:53 on number 11, by the window on the right side, a person. Was there a person in other... I swear to God.
Let's have a look.
That's Ophelia.
That's a cat.
Did they think that was a person? By the window on the right side, a person.
They've never seen a cat before? That's what I like to think. This person. Monica's never seen a cat.
Never seen a cat. Oh, she's got the falling in reverse logo.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah. So she's just on drugs. It's fine.
Yeah.
Because everybody's on drugs, Monica.
Cat follows the pulled string that yanked the can behind the couch where the person pulling the string was.
People are on drugs, mate. Everybody's on
drugs. Ophelia did react, but it was more to just the sound.
Just she got sounds, by yeah.
the
sound.
She wasn't following the string. Well, apparently she was a person. Don't forget that.
That's right. And the string went like
behind the couch.
4Ks around the perimeter of the house. Cats and dogs can see ghosts, though. Don't forget. But it's alright because Ophelia's a person. So
yeah.
It wasn't,
yeah, she could.
So it wasn't a ghost.
We got a fair few mentions though. Let's be honest, the only thing I can't handle is this guy's voice.
I mean, that's fair. Also really thought this was the butter the bread with butter.
Oh my god, yeah.
Thing.
It does look like that. Well, I handle the videos to the end. Needs scarier, mate. Do you order your McDonald's in that voice? Lols. MacDonald's. Order your MacDonald's. Lols.
This is poetic. These videos are creepy and scary for sure, but the clips about people/humans can be more scary than the paranormal scary world out there.
It's fucking deep shit.
Yeah. It's like a haiku, but he was having a stroke halfway through.
I'm early. I don't understand why people post what? Those things on, like, you know, on Instagram and stuff, they go first to try and get like the first comment. That's what he's doing. He's like, I'm early. Like, what are you getting from that?
Well, it's the easiest way to maybe have a shot at getting some attention, like, without having actually having to do anything. Yeah. First! How do you feel? You feel famous.
Mate. Look at me.
Dripping.
Look at me. I'm sick of drinking this out of the bottle.
Yeah. It can't be a good experience ever.
How do you feel?
Annoyed.
This could be our breakout moment, dude.
Of course, we appreciate stuff like this. Supporting other creators on the platform is very important.
Yeah.
I just don't understand why you can literally make a video proving that something's not real and then have part of that video used in a compilation for things that they pretend are real. This is like the cycle of everything and why we thought we would make a video asking people to be skeptical in the first place. Because shit like this just happens all the time. News and other people's videos and two straightforward example of how easy it is to like fact check a thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And how like crazy the internet can be and yeah, everyone just has to be a little bit more careful, you know?
These versions of the videos, these compilations are made for people who think of themselves as skeptics.
Mm.
And even in this situation, we end up with the same thing. Don't fall into a trap. Be skeptical, but like, try.
Yeah.
Gonna say, oh, that was fake, or something like, oh, I leave my cans lined up on the counter.
like some smart ass fucking comment.
You can say that to yourself.
Yeah.
But if you're gonna type it out for everybody else to read as if you're the fucking messiah who worked it out, do a little bit more. All of those comments were more than 3 words long.
Exactly. More than pilot error podcast typed into the search bar. Imagine if we actually scrolled through them and someone had commented like, guys, this isn't real. They made a video on this and like linked our other video.
Yeah.
But no, people don't do those things.
No, people don't do those things. You fucking do those things. It's so easy. Try, for the love of God. We're not like 100% like forgivable and we do the same shit. Everybody does the same shit. We're busy. We're gonna try. So we hope that you'll try and watch our other videos.
I think that caps it off quite nicely.
Chili.
Okay, not spicy.
No.
Mmm.
Now it just reeks of chili in here.
Okay, it is spicy.
Oh, I'm glad I didn't have to eat that.